Hello everybody, you're watching Sports Federation TV, and once again I'll be your host. I'm Lynn Yukthachetti. We've got some great sports joining us today, two amazing sports actually, sailing and bodybuilding. We'll also be showing you highlights from the transplant sport send-off, as well as footage from the Royal Yacht Club Sailing Regatta. Well, later on in the show, you're also going to get a chance to win that case of assorted bashers once again. So please stay tuned for that announcement and have your phone ready. Joining me first is Ravin Kolbe from Bodybuilding. Welcome, Ravin.
Hi, thank you for having me.
Well, tell us, how did you get involved in the sport of bodybuilding?
I started first with rugby, playing on high school level rugby, and then my mother had a friend that knew about bodybuilding, and I started with the natural bodybuilding first, and from that day onwards I was hooked.
So you started with natural bodybuilding and then you moved on to...
Yeah, then I moved on to different federations such as IFBB, PCA now, which is very well known federations in bodybuilding.
Okay. No. Well, we were fortunate enough to have natural bodybuilding on the show in a recent show, actually. For you, having done both, what would you say is the essential differences?
The essential differences from natural bodybuilding and your IFBB federations and PCA federations is the sponsorships. There's more sponsorships in your well-known federations such as IFBB and PCA, and less sponsorships in your natural bodybuilding.
Is that because you're allowed to use certain substances or enhancers in normal bodybuilding?
Basically, normal bodybuilding, just like supplements such as like sports supplements, Evox, USN, those type of brands, which you can use.
So you actually, before we get into the bodybuilding, deep into the bodybuilding stuff, you actually come from quite a sporting family, hey?
Yeah, no, definitely. My cousin, Cheslin Kolbe, which plays for the Stormers as the fullback, as well far cousin, Wade van Niekerk, which is the Olympic 400 meter champion.
Okay, so your family functions, is there a lot of competition there?
Yeah, there's quite a few. There's always, because we're very competitive, but mostly in sports, in other stages, it's more chilled.
Yeah. Okay. So, with bodybuilding, would you say the sport is growing in South Africa?
Yes, definitely. Like, look, way back, bodybuilding in SA wasn't big. There wasn't a lot of supplement brands. People just looked at food as a first source of nutrition. There wasn't sponsorships as well. Now bodybuilding in SA grew massively from different federations, as like PCA, IFBB, WBFF, more international federations is developing in South Africa.
So would you say then that funding plays a major role in how popular a sport can be?
Definitely. Without funding, I mean, sports is fun, and as you can do it, you do it as a hobby, you can also do it as a job as well. But funding in sports, it will really benefit you or improve.
The entire federation as well, and the kind of doors that would open.
Definitely.
If you excel.
Exactly. Then you can look at it as a career or just only as a hobby, depending on the funding.
Well, speaking of careers, what has been the highlights of your career thus far?
The highlights of my career is winning the IFBB Junior Championship. That was in 2015. And then recently, I guest posed at the PCA bodybuilding in Mossel Bay. Then I competed in Birmingham at the Body Power Expo as well, and I won the Conrad Nochel Extreme overall champion in bodybuilding as well as Muscle Model Plus.
Okay, so one of the world's probably most well-known bodybuilders visits South Africa annually for the Arnold Classic, Arnold Schwarzenegger. So your sport will probably be invited to that event as well, hey?
Yes, definitely. In future, I would love to meet Arnold in person, and I would definitely, that's one of my I would say, not long-term goals, but short-term goals to meet him and compete at his show.
Mm. I'm sure you've got tons of trophies at home and you've brought three of your favorite with. So you're used to big competitions, hey?
Yes, definitely. I competed Western Province, South African IFBB, South African Championships, PCA, Federations, Battle of the Titans, PCA, which is also one of the biggest shows in Cape Town as well. So I have competed at quite a number of competitions in SA, and my first competition internationally being Body Power UK.
What does it take, I mean, in terms of training for these huge competitions?
It takes a lot of dedication. I mean, it's waking up at 4 in the morning, training, afterwards, preparing your meals, then going to class, studying, then training again. So it's a lot of dedication and also commitment as well.
And discipline in terms of diet and those kind of things as well.
Yeah, definitely, because it's like a lot of my friends, my family, they like eating out and like eating obviously takeaways and stuff, where I have to opt for the healthier option where I bring my own food, I prep my own meals, and then try and diet, stick to a certain diet for like 12 to 16 weeks straight.
So with your particular sport, from the eating regime of maybe your peers as well, what would you guys fuel on?
The fuel, basically our eating regimes are egg whites, rice, chicken, oatmeal.
So protein.
Yeah, a lot of protein, carbohydrates, and a bit of fats as well, like your essential fatty acids such as your
fats,
nut butters, your omega fats and that.
All right.
Yeah.
What would you say is the most difficult part of the body to train or build on?
The most difficult part of my body to train on is definitely legs, calves, because usually, like, if you have good legs, you're genetically blessed. But for some of us who's not genetically blessed in legs or anything like that, you have to train it twice as hard as like a normal muscle group such as shoulders, chest or arms.
So is that why there's so many people avoiding leg day?
Yeah, no, definitely.
Unfortunately,
yeah, because that's why you get all this big leg day scares and memes all around social media. Yeah, that's why I feel like that is the most training muscle group to train.
Okay, yeah, I'm surprised that it's actually legs. So, you know, you've mentioned that one of your family members is quite a well-known sporting personality, Cheslin Kolbe from the Stormers. I mean, being related to people like that so closely, has it in any way inspired you or guided you into this direction?
Yes, definitely. He always motivates me. Like, we grew up together. We were very close. Like, we always, how can I say, competed to one another, but as well at the same time motivating each other and helping each other up. And that's why I'm very proud of him from where we came from where he is now. So definitely he's always been there for me in my life, and I've always been there for him. So we definitely keep that bond very close.
Hmm.
Yeah.
So we heard that you can beat Cheslin in the 100 meters. It's true.
That was back then. I don't know now. Now he's a very fast guy.
Oh, we also heard that you can beat Wade, your other cousin, in the
400
meters.
No, Wade, then I would have been Olympian champion.
What would you say is the best part of your sport?
The best part of my sport is just that hour or that 45 minutes of being free in the gym. It's like a stress reliever. It's a stress reliever. It's like I can be myself in that 45 to an hour of my day, because that's when I can basically just relax. That way a lot of people will think of it as hard work and pain, and that way I feel I'm more relaxed at the gym.
I get that. For a lot of people, their sport is their happy place.
Definitely.
No matter how tough their sport can be. So you're fully clothed today, so our viewers can't see how well developed you are for your sport. Can we show them some photos?
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
So you've written photos and...
That was taken in Birmingham.
This was a recent photo
this
then?
This is a recent photo, yeah.
So only the clouds have been photoshopped there, hey?
No, we were actually standing on top of a building.
Wow.
Me and the one well-renowned photographer, Justin Chong, and it was drizzling and I was standing there posing, which was quite nice as well. So this is real clouds, everything is real, nothing's photoshopped. Yeah.
Sure, that's a stunning photo then. And I mean, clearly by that photo as well, we can see how much of effort.
It really takes a lot of effort, yeah.
To get to that level. Wow, so this looks like the extras from 300.
Yeah.
Are these people that you've competed against?
Yes, this was junior essays in 2015. This was one of my toughest lineups ever.
Did you say juniors?
This was juniors, yeah.
Wow.
I know they look like seniors, but...
Okay. Yeah. Oh, and there you are again.
Yeah, this is a recent one as well. This was at when I won the overall title at Conrad Nochel Classics.
Yeah. Well, I've got to ask you because, you know, a lot of people have this, maybe it's a misconception that being this well defined and bulked up is painful. Is that true?
It's not painful. It's actually more... How can I say, it's tiring. It's really tiring. Like a lot of, like on that photo, we look like we one of the strongest people in the world, where you feel like one of the weakest because of like your nutrition and not taking enough nutrients and that. But like, it just gives you, just being on stage, it gives you that energy. We just wanna show everyone what hard work goes into it.
So you feel great, you're not sore, you feel
great. Yeah, you feel great, definitely.
Okay. So what's your goals now in the near future in terms of your sport?
My goals for the future sport is definitely competing in one of the top shows in the world, which would be end of the year in China, PCA. Then as well, later on, my long-term goal would be one day competing at Olympia.
Absolutely. I think that's any athlete's dream, hey?
Definitely. Too. Any athlete in the sport would love to compete at the Olympia stage because that's where all the big names are.
Okay.
Yeah.
So for those people who are maybe interested now in registering for your sport, how can they get a hold of your federation?
They can follow their website, PCA official on Facebook, as well as on Instagram, PCA SA. They can follow the sport in there and contact them via inbox or direct message.
Okay.
Like that. They can also visit the websites as well, www.pca.com.
Okay, Raven, I just got a message now on my fake earpiece. One of the viewers texted in and they said they don't believe that it's you on that photo. They think it's Photoshop, so they asked that you please remove your jacket so they can see if this is the truth.
My jacket, okay. Let's see if I can remove this bad boy.
I know the people at home are probably thinking very smooth, Lenuka.
Yeah, you played it
very smooth.
Getting
the guy to take off his shirt. Okay,
so it's true,
ladies and gentlemen, it's true. This guy is the real deal. And it's quite inspiring. And I'm sure your family is so proud of you, as well as your cousins, who are also amazing, well-known athletes.
Thank you.
Okay, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate being on the show.
Okay, great. Is there a way that people can follow you through social media?
Yeah, they can follow me on Instagram, Raven Leo, and as well on my Facebook page at Raven Kolbe. Yeah, they can follow me on those.
And Bodybuilding has a Facebook presence as well. Hey.
Yes, definitely.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Raven.
Thank you so much.
Well, that's all from Bodybuilding for now. But after the break, we'll be joined by sailing, and we've got two guests here to tell us all about the sailing world. So stay tuned. We'll be back after the break.